just when they thought it couldn't get much worse, it rained again. Already exhausted, these victims searched for shelter in the wet weather. Others fled their homes between the showers, believing a dam near the city of Peshawar could be about to burst. The rain grounded the Pakistani army's helicopters, just as officials said they were starting to make headway with the relief operation. Tens of thousands of people are now totally dependent on aid. For some, the combination of hunger and desperation has proved too much to handle.
We've lost everything. Most of our cattle have died. Many people have been killed. Our homes destroyed. The government has given us just a tent per family. Mostly it is the public that have come out to help us.
And many are angry that the country's president is now sleeping in a luxury London hotel ahead of a terrorism meeting with David Cameron on Friday. The progress of relief efforts and an estimation of how much these floods could cost Pakistan will be discussed in an emergency cabinet meeting held by the country's prime minister later today. Aid agencies argue that relief efforts must focus on stopping the spread of disease, caused in part by the bodies of drowned animals. The army says its priority is getting to those that no one's managed to reach yet and moving as many people as possible to safety. Maddie Savage, BBC News.